2011 we had an extraordinary flood event, and it demonstrated quite clearly what we might be facing in terms of future flooding with sea level rise and increased rainfall. The area traditionally floods because we've built on swampland, so we get quite a bit of rainfall that doesn't have anywhere to go. And if the coastal conditions like storm surge or a king tide cause some restrictions on the coastline, you tend to get flooding events. So the flood modelling that we're doing is basically to get an idea of what future flooding might look like for the city. Other than doing that, what we want to be able to do with the CSIRO project is actually start to model some of the solutions we're thinking about in terms of future flooding to see whether they're effective.
Essentially what the program does is it gets the information about the urban infrastructure, things like the canal, also the weather forecast data, and it comes up with a visual representation of what might happen if there was flooding. It also allows you to start putting in these mitigation options and actually evaluating them to test what's going on before committing the money to actually build the infrastructure.
From the perspective of the average engineer or council decision maker, it would be a really vital tool because it'll actually assist us to ascertain which solutions might be effective for what scenarios and for what period. And that then gives us a relatively good starting point for negotiating what infrastructure needs to go down at what cost when.